Hey, everybody, and welcome to this week's Rocksmith livestream. My name's Dan Amrick. I'm going to be your community developer now until they kick me out on behalf of Rocksmith. And what we're going to do this week is a look at Mumford & Sons. If you heard the Mumford & Sons DLC this week and thought, gee, that kind of sounds like country, before it was called country, the folks in England called it folk. So if you're not familiar with folk rock, this is actually one of the first opportunities we've had to get it into the Rocksmith library. We're going to play all three of the songs from the Mumford & Sons DLC pack. We're going to play a throwback to the 80s as our bonus song this week. We're going to give away some Ernie Ball gear for you and all kinds of other fun stuff. But of course, we start every stream with a look at the trailer. So here's the music that we'll be playing today that's available now on all platforms for Rocksmith. And when we come back, our first song and no doubt some shenanigans. So thanks for being here. We'll be right back.
It's empty in the valley of your heart. The sun, it rises slowly as you walk away from all the fears and all the faults you've left behind. The harvest left no food for you to eat. You cannibal, you meat eater, you see. But I have seen the same, I know the shame in your defeat. But I hold on hope, and I won't let you choke on the noose around your neck, and I'll find strength in pain, and I will change my ways. I'll know my name as it's cold again. And relent. Will you forgive? And I won't forget. Know what we've seen and him that laughs. Now in some way yourself, my man, you'll never be what is in your heart. Weep, little lion man, you're not as brave as you were at the start. Rate yourself and rake yourself, take all the courage you have left and waste it on fixing all the problems that you made in your own head. But it was not your fault but mine. And it was your heart on the line. I really f***ed it up this time. Didn't I, my dear? Didn't I, my dear?
Toy Machine in our chat room says that he's surprised that some people haven't heard of Mumford & Sons, but it's true. It depends on, of course, whether you listen to the radio, what kind of radio you listen to, stuff like that. We always assume that if Rocksmith is your gateway to find out something new about a new artist, then we're happy to be that sort of gateway for you. Well, you may not always like it, of course, but we do hope that we're putting in enough variety that you go, huh, that's neat. Or, huh, that's not for me, or whatever. But, yeah, we don't expect that everybody knows everything every time. So whenever somebody's on our Facebook page, they go, who? And I never know whether they mean it as, like, I'm too cool to know who these people are. But sometimes it's legitimately like, no, who are these guys? I don't know. And that's turned into some pretty good conversations when they're legitimate about it. When they're like, I would love to know more about this artist. Well, Wikipedia and Google are your friend to begin with. But, yeah, that's that. So we're going to play all three of those, starting with The Cave, which was heroically note-tracked by the one and only Jason Kokel. Hi, Jason Kokel.
Hello.
Good to see you. Chris Wu, our international product manager.
Yes, that's correct.
Yeah. Still no promotion, huh?
No.
Still stuck in that. All right.
How about you,
Dad?
Where do you go?
Intergalactic product manager? Like, how? Where do you go from international? Really?
How come you're not like universe?
No, I'm just.
You gotta expand.
No. Our community is quite large. That's the funny thing is that the community gets bigger, but my title stays the same. So that's there's no way to prove that I'm actually doing my job. Chris was jumping in on bass for this one because we asked, hey, would you like to play this?
Yep.
What did you find? Is it difficult? Is it tricky? Was it?
It's really simple.
Good.
It's very accessible. It was originally played in a lot of their early two albums, played on upright bass.
Mm-hmm. So you're playing an acoustic bass today.
It's, yeah. Kind of
in honor of that.
Yeah, exactly.
It's as close as we have. We did talk about Travis possibly bringing in one of his upright basses, but that's a colossal pain in the ass.
The logistics are just
and he ain't got
driving
no car.
Him crazy.
Yeah. That too.
We could just pull the frets off this one.
Yeah,
well,
sure.
I can do it in like 30 seconds.
Yeah, get some pliers. I'm sure Pody has some tools in his desk to make guitars both better and worse. Do you have anything you wanted to add in about this? You're playing the alternate rhythm path.
Yeah, so the reason for that is the main rhythm path that's the guitar part that the singer plays is in open D but with a second fret capo. So it was very quick with some of the internal tools that I've written for the team to transpose this to open E with no capo. So this alternate rhythm is like you still have to tune your guitar differently, but at least you won't need the extra capo.
Okay.
So I just decided to play this one because the lead is basically a hybrid of piano, banjo, and like maybe some additional electric guitar parts. And
wow.
And I was like, I don't want to play.
I just don't want to play the stream.
Yeah, I'd rather play the actual guitar part. So that's what we'll be doing today with this one.
Cool. Then let's play the actual guitar part to The Cave by Mumford & Sons, one of the three songs in this week's pack. And by the way, a lot of people are asking about the strumming patterns. I would say pay attention to Jason's hand. The strumming patterns are not notated in Rocksmith, but you will be able to pick them up from the song.
It's empty in the valley of your heart. The sun, it rises slowly as you walk away from all the fears and all the faults you've left behind. The harvest left no food for you to eat. You cannibal, you meat eater, you see. But I have seen the same. I know the shame in your defeat. But I will hold on hope, and I won't let you choke on the noose around your neck. And I'll find strength in pain, and I will change my ways, although my name as it's called. Is yours and I'll take mine. Now let me at the truth which will refresh my broken mind. So tie me to a post and block my ears. I can see where those orphans threw my tears. And know my cold despite my faults and despite my growing fears. But I will hold on hope and I down. You can understand dependence when you know their maker's mind. So make your sirens call and sing all you want. I will not hear what you have to say, 'cause I need freedom now, and I need to know how to live.
A lot of people are asking about the strumming patterns.
Oh yeah.
And I said most of them you were just doing downstrokes for where you could, but you were alternating some up and down based on, it just seemed like personal comfort level there.
Yeah, it's based on so for the palm muted stuff, I did all downstrokes because I think it sounds better than going.
Yeah.
And probably for the most part, the singer when he's strumming that part, it's all. And he's only doing the upstrokes on the 16th. But I was like, I don't want to fatigue myself, so I'll just go.
Sure.
So alternating until I feel like not doing it. And then sometimes I would just get to it and forget what this pattern was and just go. just did whatever I wanted. I'm kind of just reading and saying.
Close enough.
Because overall, I mean, I think that downstrokes sound better for the most part because the attack is definite. The up, it kind of gets all this kind of clunkiness. But fatigue makes it so that you can't do like, you know, unless you're tiring yourself out. So, yeah.
Yeah, it's whatever feels comfortable, I think, most of the time. But a lot of your accents were all downstrokes just because that's where they that's where they felt like they should land.
Yep, absolutely. Yeah, it's a fun song.
Any issues, Chris?
You all good? I mean, the main thing I was mentioning is that it's originally played on an upright, so yeah.
So you could just get turn
an upright. You know, those of you who have an upright.
Yeah, those of you who may have an upright.
Uprights
just hanging out.
To rock.
You know, I have seen electric uprights that were just the fretboard and then like a tripod. Do you have one of those? Yeah?
He has two of them. Dang.
He says in sign language. Wow. So, yeah, I'd like to try one of those. Maybe sometime you should bring one of those in, and we can check that out. But thank you both very much.
Thank you.
No problem.
We're rolling straight on into the first giveaway. Everybody loves free stuff, and hopefully you're one of those people, too. Are you part of everybody? Then you're one of the everybody that can win what you see on the screen right now. We've got a lovely pack from Ernie Ball. Ernie Ball's super busy this week, by the way, because today's the first day of the NAMM show, the National Association of Music Merchandisers. So if you have gear lust or accessory lust or anything like that, if you want to know what's coming to a store near you this year, this is the week that happens, where they are out there talking to the retailers and showing off the latest products, new guitars, new effects, new accessories, things like that. So I actually contacted our friends at Ernie and said, why don't you send me a couple of extra, you know, like send me a double batch of the prizes this time so that I don't have to bother you in the middle of the NAMM show. And they said, that's a good idea. Here you go. So they sent us plenty of guitar strings, bass strings. You're going to get a set of each. You're going to get some Wonder Wipes, which are the cleaning system, the pre-moistened towelettes that Ernie Ball does. Makes it very easy to take care of your guitar. The peg winder, which is a super simple tool that you should always keep in your gig bag or in your case for making string changes easy. Plus, you've got the brand new strap. We have a black strap in the photo, but at the moment they are silver, so it's still kind of like a nice neutral color that works with whatever you've got. We also have picks, a dozen from Ernie. I believe right now they're nylon picks. And then three of our world-famous pink Skull Boy picks that you can only get here, or if you happen to be in San Francisco, you can stop by the front desk, and if you ask the person working the front desk, may I have some Rocksmith picks, please? They will gladly hand you a few, but just don't take them all because, you know, they still cost money. So all that can be yours if you follow whatever UbiVertigo tells you to do right now in the chat room. What we do is a random giveaway of this every week. We have two of these to give away, one now, one later in the show. So if you don't win right away, don't worry. There's another chance to get it all. And if you do win, and I bring this up because we still didn't hear from somebody from last week, and there is only a 3-week expiration date before we put your prizes back in the pile and give them to somebody else. We'll need your name, your address, and your phone number, and we don't keep that for anything nasty or whatever. We're not looking to harass you or send you spam. It's just so that the delivery company knows if something goes wrong that they can contact you directly instead of sending it all the way back to us. We don't want that, and neither do you. So good luck on this giveaway. If you have any questions, UbiVertigo can answer them in our chat room, and we've got some more giveaways, not just for Ernie Ball stuff, but for free DLC a little bit later in the show as well. So we're already one song down. That means we got three to go. My name's Dan Amrick. If you're coming in a little bit late, hi, welcome. This is the Rocksmith weekly live stream that we do with the developers here at Ubisoft San Francisco. These are the folks that actually make the game that hopefully you are playing, enjoying, and learning how to play guitar and bass better than you did before you got the software. And joining me at the moment is Sam Schwartz here in the center square. Hi.
What up?
What up, Sam? And Anthony Martinez on the wing on the acoustic bass. Hello.
Hello.
Decided to run with the acoustic bass that Chris Wu brought up today.
Oh yeah,
good for you. It's a fun one. It's a nice playing bass. And last time we played it, it got a lot of compliments and a lot of questions. Ooh, what's that? What's that? Whenever we play something, so we have a wide variety of different types of guitars and basses in the office for testing purposes to make sure that they work with the game. So that whatever you might find at your local music emporium, we know that we've tried something similar or if not the same exact model. So we probably got about 30 instruments around the office, 30, maybe even 40.
Oh, maybe.
Yeah, I don't
maybe
know.
Like with these.
Yeah, yeah. With like
all the acoustics we've had.
Yeah, and then all the stuff that people bring in.
Yeah,
like, this is Shoes guitar. Like,
oh, is it? Yeah. I thought that was an... Okay. This is not the
she might
the
tell
jazz
you about
box.
It.
That
is Shoe coming? Shoe
no, coming? Shoe's not on the show
right, well,
this
he's
week.
He's not going to tell you about it, and I don't
he's
know
not.
Much about it.
All right. Wow.
But it's awesome.
It's beautiful.
It's a peerless. Yeah. I know that much.
Yeah, wow. Me too.
I read the headstock.
That's what the knowledge of the one is.
Fantastic. So, yeah, we have a lot of different guitars, and, you know, for stuff like this where it's very folksy and it's playing a lot of acoustic based instruments, we're going to pull out some of our more unusual instruments like this beautiful jazz box that you've got here.
Yeah.
You guys did I Will Wait. Which one of you did the track?
Mr. Schwartz.
That'd be Mr. Sam.
That's
How
correct.
Did it go, Sam?
It was cool. It was, it's man. So first off.
It's kind of tricky. Right?
It was super tricky. So transcribing it was a beast because almost every video that they play this this tune live, they play it a half step lower than they recorded it, right? But he plays it in a different, completely different, very strange tuning. That's I think
it's
the
like
one
open
for,
C6, right?
Yeah, but it's like a very, it's a custom C6 tuning that's that the Little Lion Man is in,
right?
So he plays that tuning live. He doesn't play it in open C sharp, which is what the rhythm guitar is in. So Anthony was doing my transcription review, and he's like, "I'm hearing voices that don't make sense with your tuning." And I was like,
"I thought they were in my head, but
sure,
no, they
I know
were,
that feeling."
No, and I was like, and then I came over to his desk, and he, you know, we were like, "I guess," and I was like, and he was like, "Look at this tuning," and I was like, "Oh, that makes a lot more sense." And I was like, "Ah, crap, I gotta do this whole thing over." So there was that element of it when we found out that the tuning wasn't like C A C G C E, which is super strange. And then the other part that was really crazy was the banjo part, because he tunes his banjo. So he tunes a banjo usually has five strings, right? And so you have the four lower strings, which are actually very similar to that of a guitar. Usually they're tuned to D, G, B, and D as opposed to a high E. But for intents and purposes, that is still basically a guitar with just a D string on top instead of an E. But then there's the fifth string that comes up that's actually above. So it'd be like where the A string is if you were talking about like a five string placement. And the A string is usually tuned to a high G above the D on top. So it's, you know, fourth string is D, you know, third string is G, second string is B, first string is D, and then the G is the fifth string above everything else.
Wow.
Which is really strange. But it allows you to do a lot of really cool picking patterns. And in this one, it's really weird because he tunes the banjo down a half step on the lower four strings, but he tunes the fifth string up a half step. So it's D flat, G flat, B flat, D flat, and then on top, instead of having a G flat, which would be in line with the tuning for the rest of the banjo, he tunes it up a half step and goes to A flat. So it's D flat, G flat, B flat, D flat, A flat, which was a nightmare to figure out.
Well, yeah, it's super unusual.
Yeah, it was super. So it was like super unusual tuning, and that's and I don't know if he does that on every song. Like the banjo player tunes differently depending on so all these weird new tunings that none of us were really used to,
and it's all on an instrument that's not natively supported by Rocksmith anyway. So you've got to transfer like, you know, the banjo tuning so that they work on guitar, and then they're bizarro banjo
tunings
to begin with.
And then you have to accommodate the playing in a way that makes sense, because you don't have a fifth string,
right,
and you still are hearing those notes, so you kind of got to figure out, you got to do a creative give and take where you're like, how can I make it still feel really good like the part, but not take away so much that or not make it sound so much like the part that I actually can't play it on guitar,
right?
And that was the challenge, and so I tried to do my best to simplify it in terms of like giving you a, like, for the most part he deviates from this just a little bit because he's not like super strict about the way he's playing it with his right hand, but he mostly does a forward roll for almost the entire song, and so I kept that pretty consistent. And
can you show what you mean by that?
Yeah, I will. Yeah, I can do it now or I can do it later, but basically let's just do it now if we got any volume. So the idea of doing a forward roll. So here are my I actually got a thumb pick today. So we're going to do thumb is your first, or I guess it's thumb, it's T. So you do T and then 1 and 2 in banjo land, right? If you're talking about picking patterns. And so you're going to do 2 T 1 2 T 2 T 1 2, and that's basically the pattern for the entire song, and it's about shifting that pattern over different chord shapes.
You've played before.
Yeah, so it's like, so, but he's doing it super fast. So that's kind of the idea, is just being able to get that roll under your fingers. And once you can kind of get that going with your right hand, then you can move the shapes around on your left hand and build up the consistency of the roll, or the speed of the roll on your right hand,
right,
which is the absolutely the most difficult part, is getting that speed to feel good and comfortable, which I had to do about 20 minutes ago.
Yeah.
So I can do this.
Yeah, everybody
really
has
hard.
Been practicing
yeah,
this
it's,
week.
It's a hard one, man.
I remember trying that roll, and it's straightforward. It makes sense.
Right.
And I got it up to speed for about 2 seconds, and
yeah,
then I fell off.
Yeah, yeah, no, it's a thing that you have to do, like, a lot. It's like like push-ups. Like,
if
it's
yeah,
like,
muscle
oh, I
memory.
Can do push-ups. It's like, if you haven't done push-ups in 6 months, you're probably going to have a hard time doing push-ups. Or if you've never done 80 push-ups in a row, it's gonna,
or
you know,
a push-up.
Or
yeah,
a push-up, yeah. Yeah. Like, 80 is going to seem like a lot. So that we're doing 80 push-ups with my little... That's what we're doing.
All right. Well, let's do it.
Yeah, let's do it.
We'll talk about it a little bit more after the song, but I Will Wait by Mumford & Sons, one of the three songs. Holy cow. Because I also want to talk about the arrangements. You're playing the main lead?
Yes,
arrangement
the lead.
On
There's
this?
There's just one lead.
There's one lead. But
yeah.
But then is there an alternate rhythm?
There's a rhythm part.
Okay, we'll talk later.
Thank you.
strong and use my head alongside my heart. So tame my flesh and fix my eyes. A tethered mind freed from the lies.
Dust Fan Twitch says this very well. Holy, this is as bad, maybe worse, than Through the Fire and Flames. This is a technique that we don't normally cover, and people are, A, first of all, super impressed with your ability to play that as smoothly and beautifully as you
thank
do.
Thank you.
But people are also very curious. Mechanical Tim says he's very curious to know how you approached building dynamic difficulty for this. Now, normally, when we teach people chords or something, we build it up a little bit at a time. We try to anchor your hand in the correct position, and then we add notes as you get better at it. This is a different beast altogether to try to teach.
This is a marvelous question, because I think we actually had a very long discussion about this. because we wanted players to be able to play notes that were close together, but the idea was we wanted them to learn the role, right? We wanted you to build up that stamina of learning the role. And so what we ended up doing was we took it we gave you the first couple of notes, right? Which I think was just these, just the blue threes, like for the sections that start on that note, or the notes that are on the lowest string, like in the middle. And then we'd give you the root of all the chords, and then I think what ended up happening was we would build the roll like one section at a time, because the way that you learn these on banjo is like you would learn it like thumb 1 2, and then you'd learn thumb 1 2 thumb 2, and then you'd learn thumb 1 2 thumb 2 thumb 1 2. Right.
Okay.
So you would learn it that way on banjo. Like, that's how I learned how to do it. Mm-hmm. And we talked about introducing it that way. So we spaced those out so you get like, okay, here's one full roll, and then you rest a little bit, mm-hmm. so your hand doesn't get too tired and have to play through all. So you get like at each chord that changes, because there's just enough space in between each chord. So there's like you can do one roll, rest. One roll, rest, and you build up the roll like that. Right?
So that it's a complete unit, so that it feels natural.
So Mechanical Tim, that is the answer to that question, is building it up that way.
And to add to that, before the rolls even come into the picture, we decided to build the chord shapes first.
Oh, that's
so
right,
yes. So that you can learn the shapes.
Right.
And then once you get those three-note shapes down, then it's all about right-hand technique.
Right, yeah. It's just about learning the chords first. That's exactly what we did. Thank you. I forgot about that. So we learned. You learn the chords first, so then you'll do, and then
exactly.
You'll be right.
I see.
And then and then you'll be,
yep,
like level 13 or something is that, and then
right.
And then it goes to
yeah.
And it's cool to break that down in Riff Repeater, because if you level that up, it'll teach you the role, and then you can...
Yeah. You can do the same thing where you play it perfectly and go, you know, like that.
I mean, you'll get it if you just work it up. Like, it's really, really hard.
But obviously, but it's worth the effort. Everybody was sort of like, holy cow, that sounds so gorgeous. And it's, you know, so, and of course, there's a lot of people that found, like, oh, gee, I'm never going to be able to learn that. But now you know how you can learn it.
Man, like,
and then a lot of thought was given into teaching you how to do that in a logical way. So this is not a tomorrow goal.
And the other thing about this,
but it's still a good goal to have,
right? And this part specifically is I tried to make it so that you could attain it as a person who's not a banjo player, because the banjo is just a different feeling instrument. There's much more string spacing, so you can pluck into those strings a lot harder, right? And so the strings move a lot more, and so you get a little bit easier. It's easier to play with your right hand, right? It's why, like, you know, like, slap bass players usually use, like, lighter strings, because there's a lot more give,
right?
So this was made so that you can learn how to kind of play banjo through this song on guitar in a way that is using pretty much open banjo shapes, right? Like, all these are fairly unique to banjo. Like, you almost never play a guitar chord like this. This is a banjo chord,
right?
Like, you know, and we didn't tune the high string down to D, so you don't get the full experience per se, but you still get a good sense of what's going on. So that's what we tried to preserve, and that's the give and take that we kind of had to make sure that you guys have an experience that's banjo-ish, but not so hard that it's unattainable. So
here's my crazy question. The rhythm part on this, that's much more standard, right?
Standard is not a word I'd use.
Is there any part of this that seems attainable?
The bass is doable.
Bass totally, yeah. The rhythm track, I would say that it's
attainable for sure.
It's more hum and strummy.
Yeah,
for sure.
This is the part that you were playing a little bit earlier in the day, right? Mm-hmm. But it's just super fast.
It's very fast. But it builds in, you know, with the same Rocksmith method, like, the, you know, it sticks to the tradition of building up chord shapes. Mm-hmm. So you learn it, you know, you learn each shape one note at a time, and then come the very fast strumming patterns.
Right.
And then at that point, it's just a test of endurance. But that is also a fun arrangement to play.
Yeah, it's really cool to play in an open tuning.
Yeah, open C sharp.
Open C sharp, which I've never heard of anybody tuning to open C sharp before. Mm-hmm.
First for the library.
Yeah, I think it's registered as a custom tuning in the library.
It is. Yeah.
Yeah. So, like, so because it's, I mean, we have open D, but like,
right.
So it's like, okay, open C sharp. Like, let's do it.
And John LR 2000 asks, pick or no pick on the lead? You're using a thumb pick.
I'm using a thumb pick.
But then doing the roll with your other fingers, which is the traditional way that banjo players do it, right?
Yeah. As a guitar player, you can actually do it like hybrid picking style. Like, you can actually hold a pick with your first finger and your thumb, and you can do it like that. But I choose to do it, I played banjo for a while, so, like, that was easier for me to wrap my head around, and it's easier to hit the notes and the rolls the way that he does it with that technique. So
cool. Thank you much.
You're welcome.
You should go ice that, and we're going to take a look at a video.
My thumb is blue.
I know, right? I believe this is a session mode. Do I have that one right over there, gang? Yes, I'm getting a nod.
Yeah.
So one of the many things, beyond just very difficult folk rock songs that you can find in Rocksmith, we have a lot of things. We have a score attack mode. We have a guitarcade to help you build up some of your skills in fun little mini games. But then we also have session mode, which is something that I don't think you'll find anywhere else. Imagine starting to play guitar, and then the band behind you automatically picks up on what you're playing and follows your lead. Here's a little story about what session mode is and what you can possibly get out of it for your own playing regimen. And while you watch that, we'll swap some people out, and we're going to play a song from the 80s when we get back. So stick around.
In session mode, you're in control of your own reactive band. This isn't like a static backing track or a metronome or a drum loop or anything. These are AI musicians that are actually listening to what you're playing, and that musician has a bag of tricks. They have their riffs and their ideas that they want to offer into the jam session. So this is session mode, and right now, I've hooked up a drummer, an AI musician that's just been waiting for me to play with him. So when I start playing, the drummer starts playing with me. If I play really quiet and subdued, the drummer's also gonna play really chill along with me. But if I start playing harder and ramping up the intensity, the drummer is gonna follow me. But we wanted to do more than just playing along with the drummer. So we went further, and we actually made a whole band of AI musicians to play along with. So you'll notice at the bottom of the screen is the Rocksmith interface. And right there in the center is the scale. What session mode is telling you is, play any of those notes and it's gonna sound good with the band. We have over 75 instruments for you to choose from. We have tons of different drums, different basses, guitars, keyboards, a bunch of synthesizers. You can affect the volume and the pan of each of the AI musicians. You can affect the tempo. You can change anything about your virtual jam session. Session mode actually has a lesson plan built into it, and that's the mission system. First mission, all you have to do is just play with your drummer. Later missions, add a couple more instruments, speeding you up all the way to be able to actually improvise and start creating on your own. Session mode isn't just for guitar. It also works with bass, even works in multiplayer. So you can have your friend come over, you can play bass, he can play guitar, and you guys can play along with a virtual band. So we're really excited about what we've done, and we're very proud to continue to push forward new ways to learn and create.
Gang, it's coming October 2013. Did you see the slate at the end of the video? Are you ready? Were you ready? Are you still ready? My name is Dan Amrick. I'm the community developer on behalf of Rocksmith here, and you have stumbled upon the Rocksmith live stream. Every week, the developers here at Ubisoft San Francisco take the time out of their ridiculously busy schedules. We unshackle them from the desks, and we ask them to come out and perform and play the songs of the week that would be the DLC of the week. And this week, of course, it's Mumford & Sons, but there's only three songs, and we usually like to play four songs. So Brian Pody came up with a brilliant idea, which is so obvious, I can't believe I didn't come up with it myself. He's like, you know, you always pick like a fourth song, and I always try to match to the genre. He goes, but you know, there's the iOS songs that we do, because we're in soft launch in Canada right now for an iOS version, a free-to-play version of Rocksmith that will be coming to everybody else eventually. But he's like, why don't we play one of those as the featured song? And I'm like, well, duh, yeah, that totally makes sense. So that's what we're going to do now. And to do that with me is Travis Kindred and Brian McCune, who are over here making each other smile with little musical jokes, I think. Hi.
That's all we do.
Is that all you do?
Yeah.
Oh, their mics aren't on, though.
That's all we do.
No, I like it that
day,
way. Please,
every
I don't like the competition.
It's so much worse
Someone
now.
Someone put Anthony in the boo box.
No. You can always keep everybody else's mics. I have so many words to offer. I will speak for both of you. That's fine. We'll do it.
I guarantee that if my mic gets turned up.
Yeah. Thank you. Checks in the mail, Anthony. Yeah. Brian McCune is our manager of musical content. He's
Hello.
The one with the lovely Gibson SG with the P90s in it. And over there is Travis Kindred. Hello, Travis.
Hello.
With the Ernie Ball Music Man Caprice. Somebody
yes,
asked
very
me
fun.
What my favorite guitar was in the office, and I said, you know, I'm the things that I really like. I like the Gibson Nighthawk. That's kind mm-hmm. of a lot of fun to play.
Oh yeah.
That's on loan, so that's sort of like. It's not ours, but they're not asking for it back anytime soon.
Yeah.
So, and I really love that bass, and I like the Epiphone Viola bass as well.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we've got it's sort of funny. We've got a lot of really nice bases here.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of a nice little like treat for me every day. I'm like, "Oh, what bass do I want to play today?"
Travis is primarily a bassist. You self-define as a bassist.
I self-identify as a bassist.
Yeah, many orchestras you play bass and you mm-hmm. do play upright bass. I mean, we're talking about the fact that Mumford & Sons play a lot of mm-hmm. this material on acoustic upright basses mm-hmm. and in your copious free time, are you still working at the luthier where you help build and repair them?
I'm not at the shop right now. Okay. And I still obviously play a lot, you know. I just finished a 3-month run of Tom Waits' Black Rider with the book written by William S. Burroughs. We did 52 public performances and I think 8 previews, and then a month of rehearsals before that. So that was all on upright and tuba and ukulele. And so
at once,
there were times where I had the ukulele and bass at the same time. There were many times where I had to like quickly put down the bass, quickly pick up a tuba, stuff like that. It was very fun. That's very much my thing. I kind of that circus style of like, oh, which instrument am I going to play now? It's actually fewer than the instruments I tend to play in like the more circusy style shows. Especially for upright, like that's my wheelhouse, you know. It's really fun and it's great to listen to all the Mumford & Sons songs because they have these really great full bass sounds that you get from an upright. You know, there's just no way of really replicating that, you know, without a giant bass shaped box.
Right. And Brian, do you actually own a vibraphone? Because you're a percussionist, according to your degree, right?
Correct.
So that's not a drummer. Would you like to define what a percussionist
Ooh.
Is?
It's the person who gets to play on all the toys and schleps a lot of gear.
Yep.
So I don't own a vibraphone. It's a bucket list item for me. Mm-hmm. But there happens to be one that belongs, I think maybe, or is on loan to the orchestra that I play
yep.
for. So I got together with Matt Montgomery and Brendan West last night, and we just made some music. I played vibraphone.
Oh,
Matt
cool.
played violin, and Brendan made a lot of sounds come out of the guitar.
Oh, yep. I didn't know how that sentence was going to end, because Brendan West is capable of making a lot of
exactly,
sounds come
yeah.
out of somewhere.
To say that he was playing is kind of a stretch, yeah. but he was playing. You know.
Right. Yeah. Sure. Yeah. Understandable. We like to pick on Brendan, but Brendan's the guy that's responsible for all those great tones that you hear in the.
Yeah, he's our chaperone.
Yes, he's our tone chaperone. So now that we've set up all these beautiful things that we've talked about, vibraphones and tubas and ukuleles and exotic instruments, you're going to play guitar and bass on like a total pop rock hit from the 80s.
Yes.
And we looked at what's out, and we'll go over this a little bit later, what's available this week on mm-hmm. iOS in Canada, but. This was by far the first song that everybody was like, oh, can we do that one? Just because we like playing that one. And
yeah.
I nominated you because I believe that Footloose by Kenny Loggins is one of the toughest bass lines in the game.
Oh, interesting.
It is for me.
Yeah,
it moves.
It is not the easiest one.
Yeah.
That's for sure. It is quite difficult. But the nice thing is that it's there are some songs that have... a lot of moving bits, right? The patterns are constantly changing, and that's great. And
I'd put Black Betty in that category.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And I Want You Back is actually a really great example of that, where the bass line's constantly the same but very different. Like the ornamentation is like drastically different. This does a little bit more of the recycling. Like for me, like, you know, I popped it on and was like, 100%, let's try it. And I totally bombed the first time. And then I just did it again at like 90, 85% speed and then cranked it up, maybe played it twice, 3 times. Fine. Because once you unlock the pattern, it's no longer this mystery of like, oh, gosh, what are these notes are just coming out of nowhere. There's actually a pretty solid like, oh, that's where they are.
Okay.
And you get what I always say is being able to play music isn't about being extremely like super magically talented. It's just about knowing how it goes, right? Once you know how it goes, you know what to look for. You're not surprised when something happens. And so once you know how this one goes, it's actually really fun, like super fun.
Yeah. Brian, does the guitar follow the bass
on
this
path
one?
It does.
Yeah. You're playing lead guitar.
I am.
And I've been enjoying, we sit next to each other, so I've been enjoying hearing you practice this and run through this. And you've been going into Riff Repeater and slowing it down a little bit when you needed to get it under your fingers and mm-hmm. feel a little bit more confident. That's why Riff Repeater is there,
yeah.
so that you can slow down or repeat certain sections of the song and keep it at pitch, but just play it slower so that you can get it. But it sounded really good.
Thank you.
So
yeah,
don't screw up.
We were all really surprised.
Yeah, we were stunned.
My approach this time was yesterday when I practiced, I had it just drop me in at my sight reading level, and I just let the level design kind of teach me the essence of the song. And then today, for the phrases that I'd still not leveled up all the way, I just took them in a riff repeater, leveled them up, and slowed it way down, and did my 3% increments.
Mm-hmm.
And
metronome push-ups.
Yeah, and if I can break 90, I'll be happy.
All right.
Mm-hmm. And if I don't break 90, I'll be happy.
Okay, that's good. You know, that sounds good.
It's a win-win scenario.
It's hard to be sad when you hear Footloose by Kenny Loggins anyway.
That's
so
true.
Let's play it. Nathan East did this bass line, by the way.
Oh, is that
one of my favorite players.
Yeah.
Especially of that era in the 80s and 90s. Nathan East is a monster. Fantastic bass player.
It's very much like the end result of the blues bass line.
Yeah. So this is available in all versions of Rocksmith, and now, as of this week, on iOS. We'll talk a little bit about that when we're done the song. Taptacular, thank you.
Can you turn my headphones up?
Yeah. How's that?
More.
That's all I can do to not sing along.
It's so much more relaxing to play at my desk. Nerves are going, know that people are watching.
Yep.
That was Nathan East. Now take a hold of your soul. Singing.
That was awesome.
It was great for a song that ends on a definite stinger.
Right.
Oh, that's the best I've done.
Oh, is it really? 99.1?
Definitely the best I've done, too.
92.1.
Oh, nice. Hey, you did
it. That's great. Way to go.
That's a good fist of bumper.
Well done.
It was the least I've ever sung. I had to talk. I used to sing in an 80s band, and there's video out there. Yeah. There's video out there. I don't know if there's video of us doing Footloose, but I had to convince the band that that would be a good one for us to do.
Ooh.
And they're like, well, what? Like, what are people going to do? I said, dance. And they did. Like, anytime that no matter where we put it in the set list, that was the magnet. And then once we had them, we had them. And I'm like, okay, why don't we just start with Footloose at a set? And so that became something that we did at the beginning. And yeah, I just, what a hell of a fun song.
Oh, I mean, it's built into, like, the every part of the song is that you have to move.
Yeah.
You know,
it's
so hard
to stay still.
Yeah, yeah. It's one of those things where it's not like, oh, long day at the office. I just want to sit on the couch and listen to Footloose. Like, that does not happen.
It does not happen. Yes. Excellent.
Yeah.
Thank you both.
Yeah, yeah. Brian, Nate, very good job.
Yeah,
oh,
excellent
thank
job.
You.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You done good.
Oh, thank you. I practiced a little bit.
Good. Yeah. Practice is good for you.
I do want to say just like one thing that I chose to do different.
No, go ahead.
Oh, wait. Dan, are you exasperated at someone wanting to talk to you?
No, go ahead.
sorry.
Oh, my gosh.
That little section with the build up, the chromat. No, that's not it. And then Sam had it tracked, which is probably how it's performed.
Mm-hmm.
To go back
switching
to
an open string.
I kept that all on the blue string for that ascending line.
Oh,
sorry. What?
Yeah.
I'm definitely not in tuning. And I ended here because the next part is. So it's right here instead of
having to come from
down here.
That seems comfortable too.
So as long as the pitch is the same, you'll pass detection, find what works for you. That's just one example.
You still got 92.4%.
Yeah, I did.
And we're all still very impressed.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
Absolutely.
I'm impressed at my intonation right now. I sound really good.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's warm up here in the streaming room in Ubisoft San Francisco. What are you going to do? Studio R, as I started to call it, for Rocksmith.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
I like it.
Yeah. Hey, can I talk now? Is that okay?
Dan,
can I be the hosty guy?
Hey, let the record show. Dan actually asked permission to talk.
Yeah, I know. It's a very rare thing. Hey, in case you missed it, kids, if you're enjoying the Mumford & Sons vibe, you may go Mumford & Who Else? Because there's not a lot that we have in the library that sounds quite like Mumford & Sons. Again, this is very strong folk-influenced stuff from the UK, and there's some rock elements to it, but the folk is really what shines through. So I found a couple of five songs here in our library of things that may not exactly line up, but if you are digging the vibe, then you might dig the songs that you see on the screen right now. Give these a shot. Some of these are in packs, some of these are singles. Stuff like Drunken Lullabies by Flogging Molly, that's going to be the same sort of intensity as some of the faster Mumford songs. But then things like The Funeral by Band of Horses and Little Talks of Monsters and Men, I think, is a really good one to recommend for this kind of thing. So if you're enjoying this stuff, you may not have realized that some of these songs are in our library. And if you like the vibe and you'd like to, say, create your own little song list, and practice all these things. These are tracks that I would recommend that you look into. And as we said, of course, the iOS version features Footloose this week. Let's see the iOS songs for this week. We actually have two packs, one of which is a five-pack of Deftones songs, which is pretty great. All of those are available now as of this week in the Canadian iTunes store. Plus, we do have that three-pack of 80s songs, which has Footloose and Rat, Lay It Down, and Huey Lewis in the News, Hip to Be Square. We recently got Huey Lewis in the library, and that's something that I was hoping we would be able to get for some time, because they are, of course, Bay Area. Huey Lewis comes out of the San Francisco Bay Area. We always like to take care of our own and get them in the library whenever we can. So, if you are looking for fresh tunes to play in the iOS version, as I've said before, the iOS version is currently available in Canada in the iTunes store. It is free to play, and we are continuing to evolve it. In fact, this week it was patched again, And we intentionally do that. I mean, it's not like, oh boy, we had to patch it again, but we're actually adding more functionality. One of the things that we added this week was the ability for capo songs to be part of the library. Right now, until this week, that wasn't possible. So you're going to see some different kinds of songs that use capos, will start appearing in the iOS. So, of course, the question on everyone's lips and the answer in no one's ears, apparently, seems to be, when is this coming out outside of Canada? And honestly, the answer is when it's damn good and ready. And not when we're damn good and ready, but when the product is actually at the point that we feel comfortable bringing it out worldwide with many more features and stuff. So I'll let you know. You know I'm going to let you know when it's available. Until then, if you are in Canada and you have access to it, you have an iOS device, whether that's an iPhone, an iPad, or an iPod Touch, it's a free app. We'd love to hear what you think about it. We've got a dedicated area at the forums at rocksmith.com where we want to hear from you. And we also absolutely welcome your iTunes reviews as well. Even if they're not super complimentary, we need to know what you think we could be doing better so that we can do it better. Hi, Brian Pody.
Hello.
What's going on? You were sort of shaking your head and being like, no, I can't get this thing. Is everything okay? Are you going to be able to play this song, this last song here on our stream?
I mean, train wrecks happen.
Okay. So I had said earlier, Brian Pody, one of our note trackers here, I had said earlier that everybody had practiced this week. And I realized everybody asterisk Brian Pody, who's often too busy and or likes to live dangerously. So I take it you didn't get too much time.
I played it once.
You did play it once, about half an hour before we went on the air, if I recall.
Yeah. It's like I have to go back to my desk.
This song is Little Lion Man. This is the third of the songs in the Mumford & Sons pack. And I found this comfortable and easy on bass up to a point because I just wasn't ready for... I'm used to playing when I play rock bass. You know, I'm anchored on the E or the A. So many songs are anchored on those lower two strings. Mm-hmm. This one kind of starts and floats around the D string, the blue string. Mm-hmm. Most of the time, and then it calls back. It actually walks down to the lower string. So that's threw me for a loop a little bit, but I still did okay.
Yeah. So we've talked about these songs being played on upright bass.
Yes.
On the record. So yeah, you're seeing a lot more stuff in lower positions on the D and even the G string than you would in most typical like rock bass lines, because those bass players are gonna stick to those lower strings and just move up the neck. But the upright players do a lot less of that, and they'll play much more in open positions and in the low positions.
Yeah. Guitar-wise, you've got a capo. I was just talking about capos. You're on the fifth fret.
Yeah.
Which version are you playing? Are you playing rhythm path or
a
lead path here?
I'm going to play the rhythm guitar because, like in the other tunes, the lead path is the banjo part.
Right.
And I want to play the guitar part. The guitar part's actually really fun.
Okay.
And this is that like custom C6 tuning that Sam and Anthony were talking about. That's C, A, C... G, C, E.
Yeah, that's an oddball tuning no matter how you cut it.
So you leave three of the strings the same? Is that right? Yeah. The A, the G, and the E are all the same.
Okay.
And then everything else just becomes a C.
Great. That's easy to remember, but probably difficult to do in the first place. Like, what leads you to do that? Who knows? Any weird strumming patterns? A lot of people are curious to have insight into the strumming patterns this week because they are pretty intense.
The strumming pattern's super hard to get your head wrapped around. I make no guarantees
about
how well I'm going to do for that. This one was really kind of hard to nail the tempo map on, and thank you for Travis because he's the one who finally got it put together. Because especially when the guitar is on its own, it's really hard to feel where the beat is. Because he like plays kind of all around the beat, and just in a weird way, the strumming pattern's bizarre.
All right. Well, let's give it a shot. Little Lion Man by Mumford & Sons, one of the three songs in this week's Mumford & Sons DLC pack. Hopefully you're finding things here that maybe catch you by surprise. Again, some people were kind of just surprised to find that this was in our game at all. But there's clearly plenty to learn from this kind of material.
Weep for yourself, my man, you'll never be what is in your heart. Weep, little lion man, you're not as brave as you were at the start.
rate yourself and rake yourself. Take all the courage you have left and waste it on fixing all the problems that you made in your own head. But it was not your fault but mine, and it was your heart on the line. I really picked it up this time, didn't I, my dear? Didn't I, my dear? Tremble for yourself, my man. You know that you have seen this all before. Tremble, little lion man. You'll never settle any of your scores. Your grace is wasted in your face. Your boldness stands alone among the wreck. Now learn from your mother, or I'll spend your days biting your own neck. But it was not your fault but mine. Your heart on the line. I repeat it up this time. Deny my dear. It was not your fault but mine. And it was your heart on the line. I repeat it up this time. Deny my dear.
I'm always afraid of missing that final note, even though it's all alone, because it's all alone. Because I'm like, false sense of confidence. Everything's gone. There's no notes on the thing. That's fine. I'm gonna, there it is. So, hey, I'm glad I got it. And not bad for me. It's a lot of fun.
It is. It's a really fun song. And I think because of the bizarro tuning, like kind of everything you do sounds good, you know?
Right, even open, it's kind of got a life to it.
Yeah, most of the chords are just one or two fingers. There's one chord that uses three fingers, and that's the most, like,
where's it going?
Right.
Where's it going?
Yeah, it's leading somewhere.
Yeah. So it's really fun to play. It's easy to wrap your head around the changes.
Right.
Because they're mostly just one or two fingers. It's just the rhythm that's hard to lock into.
Yes. Well, I mean, you know, it's really fast and it's very specific. But you dropped into it very quickly. I know you were a little, you were like, well, I don't know what's going to happen. But you made it sound real nice. So,
Once the banjo comes in, the banjo's just like straight 16th notes for the most part. It's just one yanda, two yanda, three yanda, four yanda. It's a little easier to lock in once you have the banjo to really like
sync up with. Yeah.
Yeah, but when it's the guitar on its own, it's like, whoa, where am I?
Come on, rhythm guitarists, this is your chance to shine. I'm always out there encouraging my fellow rhythm guitarists to step up and be like, that's easy, just strum things. That's great.
Yeah, it's a really fun arrangement though, and yeah, this is a good week to be like, yeah, rhythm.
Yeah, it's a very good week for rhythm guitarists. So embrace it, embrace your destiny. Thank you, Mr. Pody.
Yeah, thank you.
Hey, it's time for the next and final giveaway of our show. We gave away a pack of these, one of these Ernie Ball prize packs at the beginning of the show, and this is time to make good on doing the the second one. Everything you see here is going to go home with somebody. Maybe that somebody is going to be you. Are you the kind of person that uses, say, guitar strings or bass strings or both? You're going to get a set of regular Slinky guitar and bass strings, one of each, in this package. You're also going to get a peg winder, which makes changing those strings a lot easier on your guitar. You're going to get a brand new strap. We've got they've got them in silver at the moment, so hopefully that matches or complements something that is in your stable. I know black is a very popular guitar color, so why not mix it up a little bit with a silver strap on that? You might be surprised at how good it looks. The Wonder Wipe system is a care and maintenance system from Ernie Ball. It's a guitar polish, it's a string cleaner, and it's fretboard moisturizer. It just basically makes your guitar feel and play a lot better if you just take care of it. And this is a nice, easy way to do that. So you'll get a sampler pack, a couple of each of those things that I just called out, so you can try them out. And, of course, a brand new pack of picks, a dozen from Ernie Ball, and just three from us because we're stingy. But they are the pink ones that you see there that you can only get here on the Rocksmith stream. All of this can be yours if you win. UB Vertigo is currently running a raffle in our room. Moobot is going to randomly determine who the winner is, and that could be you. We wish you nothing but good luck. And thank you again to Ernie Ball for the kind, kind donation of the prizes. Again, they are busy this week doing the NAMM show, the National Association of Music Merchandisers. Basically, this is the big trade show. What E3 is for video games, the NAMM show is for the music industry. So new guitars, new basses, new effects pedals, new everything is debuted generally at this show. So we know that they're very busy, but they sent us over the prizes in advance so that you can have them soon. So the faster, if you win, the faster you send UB Vertigo your name, your address, and your phone number, then he will send them on to me, and the quicker I can get them out to our mailroom, and then they can get out to you. Somebody won last week and didn't actually send us their address, so you might want to check your other list here on Twitch. In the private messages, there's a sort of a column from people that you know and your friends, and then there's a column for people that maybe you aren't friends with, that they still want to contact you. A lot of times, that's where UB Vertigo's message to you to say, hey, you won, please confirm your address privately, because we don't want you posting it in the chat room. You know, that's a whole bunch of extra hassle you don't need. But do please check that, because if we don't hear from you after 3 weeks, we just figure you forfeit and we move on to somebody else. So if you want to win the prizes, you got to check your messages. We didn't do a Q&A this time, so real quick, while I'm doing this final patter, if there's any specific questions, I did tackle a couple of questions during the show, and I always like to do that, but you can hit me with some questions now while I'm doing my my outro. Also, if you have questions that we didn't answer this week, you can reach us on social media, at Rocksmith Game on Twitter or /Rocksmith on Facebook. Those are the two most direct ways to get a hold of us. And if you're looking for more information on the studio or maybe the South Park game, you may have noticed the South Park stuff over my head. Happy to say that Ubisoft San Francisco is also the studio that brought you South Park The Fractured But Whole, available now on pretty much every platform. And more DLC coming out for that title very soon. So if you're not familiar with that, it's the latest South Park RPG saga. It's really fun, especially if you're a fan of the show. I don't think you'll be disappointed. But you can find us on Twitter at Ubisoft Studio SF or /Ubisoft Studio SF over on Facebook. Let's see. We should add songs from insert a band name here, says Gabe. So for those of you who don't know, we do have a request page on our website, rocksmith.com/requests. We do take that data seriously. We had another meeting this week about future DLC and what should be prioritized. And you know what really helps us prioritize which tracks we request when we get the licenses for them? It's your requests that say, I really want to play these songs. That helps bubble things up to the top so that when we get the opportunity to approach the rights holders, the artists, or their management, or both, you know, we can say these are the songs that are the most important to our audience that they would most like to play. These are the ones that we do. And we're very happy when we can present them with the stuff that we know are the songs that everybody wants and then go bang, 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 bang and get them all. So if you have any suggestions for DLC, we really do want to hear them. Just type in the song title and the artist At our website at rocksmith.com requests. And honestly, it's not a black hole. It really does go into a big-ass database that Brian McCune checks every day. Let's see. Is the next Encore topic and presenter known already? As a matter of fact, it is, and I'm glad you brought that up, Beatmaster 80, because for those of you who maybe knew or just have forgotten over the holidays, what we try to do at the end of every month is a Rocksmith Encore, a bonus stream on the last Monday of the month, and that stream... will be something that isn't like just, you know, DLC based the way that we normally do our stream. It's generally something a little bit more educational or personal. Like, for instance, we had Brendan West on to come and talk about effects pedals and how they work and sort of the basics. The Guitar Effects 101 went over very well. We'll probably bring him back for a Guitar Effects 201 at some point. Arthur von Nagel, one of our producers, is a huge metal fan and of course played in the death metal band Cormorant. So he offered us all a look at sort of the anatomy of metal, not just the history, but you know, there's speed metal, there's power metal, there's death metal, there's black metal, there's all these different subgenres of metal, and it can get really confusing. He sat down and explain it for an hour and a half. So if you've ever wanted that insight, that's available on Twitch TV. That we have all of these in our video archive. So if you want to check them out, you can. And we'll be adding another one to the family this Monday. I believe we have a slide for this too, because Brian McCune is coming back and he's going to do the Physics of Sound Part 2, the very first Encore that we did. And Encore, honestly, is Brian McCune's baby. He suggested it in the first place. So that's what we're going to do. He's got more to talk about the Physics of Sound. That's Monday. That's this coming Monday, which I believe is the 29th. I'm still looking for that slide, Pody. Please help me. is it the 29th? But it's going to be at our normal time, which is 3 p.m. Pacific, 6 p.m. Eastern, 11 p.m. GMT. And we will also do some giveaways during that as well. We've got some DLC, and I believe Black Widow is going to be here to be our chat moderator for that one. Not sure. But we've got stuff for you. Oh, you had it all set up, I thought. Did something go wrong? Well. Oh, it's in the off-the-air thing? Oh, all right. So we'll leave you with a look at that plug. How's that? That's better. I understand now. Never mind. Don't worry about it. Please do come back and join us on Monday at 3 p.m. That's just a few days away from now, and we'll do a special bonus stream. You will have the opportunity to ask questions. Brian McCune is putting together his syllabus right now, and basically we're going to probably pick up where we left off. If you'd like to watch the first part, that's available on in our twitch.tv archive of shows, and so that would probably be good to do, is see what we've talked about already so you know what to expect and maybe come with some questions that Brian can answer for part two. So we would love to see you on Monday if you're available. Also, of course, we will have some new DLC next week on Tuesday. What's that DLC going to be? I'm sure you'd like to know, and that's why we're going to give you a hint tomorrow in the forums at rocksmith.com. Every Friday, we try to put up a little sort of puzzle or a clue or something that you have to work together to figure out what it really all means with your fellow Rocksmith players in our forums. And we've got one of those ready to go. Rolling Stone 222 is the guy that makes our puzzles, and he's come up with a good one. I'm just going to say, like, when he told me what it was, I was like, okay, that's cool, but you're going to have to put your thinking caps on to break through on this one. So at the end of that puzzle, if you solve that clue, you will get confirmation of at least one of the songs that's coming next week in the DLC. So we'll see you tomorrow at the forums at rocksmith.com. We'll see you Monday back here on twitch.tv for the Physics of Sound Part 2 with Brian McCune. And hopefully we'll see you next Thursday as well, because we'll be back to do this show one more time with all new music next week. My name's Dan Amrick. I'm the community developer. Thank you so much for joining us. I saw a couple of fresh new faces out there, too. Really appreciate that. Hopefully you liked what you saw. And if you did, you know, feel free to spread the word. This is free. You don't even have to pay anything. And we give you stuff to show up. So tell your friends, and we'll leave you with a look at the Mumford & Sons 3-song DLC pack that's available right now in Rocksmith on all platforms. Thanks very much. See you next week, everybody. And, you know, hopefully see you Monday.
It's empty in the valley of your heart. The sun, it rises slowly as you walk away from all the fears and all the faults you've left behind. The harvest left no food for you to eat. You cannibal, you meat eater, you see.
but I've seen the same. I know the shame in your defeat, but I will hold on hope, and I won't let you choke on the noose around your neck, and I'll find strength in pain, and I will change my ways. I'll know my name as it's cold again. Forgave, and I won't forget. Know what we've seen and him at last. Now in some way shape the excess. My man, you'll never be what is in your heart. Weep, little lion man, you're not as brave as you were at the start. Rate yourself and rake yourself, take all the courage you have left, and waste it on fixing all the problems that you made in your own head. But it was not your fault but mine, and it was your heart on the line. I really f***ed it up this time, didn't I, my dear? Didn't I, my dear?